Chapter number one, homeostasis. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Homeostasis in plants. Homeostasis in plants. We are discussing here process of homeostasis in plants. As you know that homeo means same and stasis means state. Homeostasis is actually the process of maintenance and regulation of any living system. Any living system means any organism with response to external changes. In this chapter, we will discuss the homeostasis, process of homeostasis, then its aspects, three aspects of homeostasis, osmoregulation, thermoregulation, and excretion. After that, we will discuss the feedback system. Feedback system is a check and balance mechanism. We check the changes and balance it, maintains it. Then later on, we categorize the plants on the basis of osmoregulation. We classify the plants on the basis of osmoregulation, and then we also discuss the process of excretion in different ways and all that things which a plant has to excrete out and why does a plant doesn't have problem in the process of excretion. Homeostasis in plants. Again, we are repeating that home means homeo or home means same. Stasis means state. It is a regulatory mechanism which maintain and regulate the internal environment of an organism or any living body with response to change in external environment. It can be any change. It can be change in temperature. It can be change in salt and solutes and solvents. It can be change in the metabolic status of the body. So in this way, we can say that plants also has to remove all the extra waste products from the body. These waste and harmful and poisonous things can be different things. Like gases has to be removed, carbon dioxide and oxygen. Then water has to be removed. If plant has the surplus amount of water, it has to remove from the body. And as it is, it has some metabolic byproducts which has to be removed, like latex and gum and some other things like rubber. These all things, latins, these all things also have to, resins have to remove from the body. So there are different ways to remove these metabolic waste and poisonous substances and gases and water. All this process is combinedly called excretion. And when a plant is maintaining solutes and solvents, it is called osmoregulation. And when plant is maintaining temperature, it is called thermoregulation. Now we are discussing about the homeostasis aspects. Aspects of homeostasis. There are three aspects of homeostasis. Number one, osmoregulation. Number two, thermoregulation. Number three, excretion. When we are talking about osmoregulation is actually the maintenance and regulation of solutes and solvents of any living system. When we are talking about osmo comes from osmosis and it means to push. To push means movement of solutes and solvents. Solutes are salts and nutrients, and solvents is water in the plants. So these two things move from one cell to another cell by osmosis, and regulation of this process or maintenance of this process is called osmoregulation. Now we come to the thermoregulation. This is the second aspect of plants' homeostasis. Thermoregulation is maintenance and regulation of temperature in any living system with response to change in external environment. Do you know that temperature is very, very effective to survive? There is a critical range of temperature to survive that is from 0 degree centigrade to 35 degree centigrade on which living things can survive. It is a suitable range. When 35 degree centigrade temperature raised from 35 degree centigrade, all living organisms, either plants and human beings and animals, they all suffer from the temperature stress, from high temperature stress. As it is 0 degree centigrade, till 0 degree centigrade, it is suitable. But after that, when the temperature is in minus degrees, it is low and freezing point at that plants and animals both are facing the freezing stress. This is called freezing stress. To face these two things, there are many metabolic changes which occurs in the plant. If sudden freezing temperature occurs, if sudden from 0 to minus 10 or minus 15 will be happened in that environment, then it causes the denaturing of enzymes and crystalline formations, and in this way cell damage and die. As it is at the high temperature, when we are facing 50 degrees centigrade or 55 degrees centigrade, all the enzyme become denatured, and denaturing of enzyme also affected the solubility of cell membrane. So that's why temperature maintenance is required. Maintenance and regulation of temperature is very important for survival of any living system. So for this purpose, all the organisms, all living bodies, plants and animals both, they do some changes and some modification to survive in both these two, low temperature and high temperature. In these both areas, in these both categories, they are facing the stress and they have to maintain and regulate in different ways. Now we come to the excretion. Excretion is actually the removal of extra waste, poisonous substances and byproducts of metabolic activities like photosynthesis and respiration. In this way, all these things have to remove from the body, and this is called excretion. Understand? There are two processes of excretion in the for water, that is called transpiration and gutation. There are two methods, transpiration and gutation. These two are removing the water. And for the removal of carbon dioxide and oxygen, that is just two ways, from the roots and sometimes from the stomata. And cuticle also has the ability to remove the extra amount of carbon dioxide and oxygen. Then we come to the byproducts which store in the leaves, like latex, like resins and gums and rubbers. These all things also removed from the body in different ways. Sometimes these substances stored in the leaves, and during the autumn and autumn season, when autumn comes, leaves remove from the body of plant and they fall down, and due to this, by this process, extra waste products removed from the body. Another way is this: you have seen a plant kicker, it has some pores on the bark or stem of the plant, and resins and sometimes gum is coming out from the body of the, from the stem, from the lenticles of the bark. Okay, I hope so you all understand. Now we come to the next point, that is home assignment. It is very important. Today we study what is homeostasis and and its aspects, and we also learn how these aspects work and how it is important for the plant. Understand? So you will do just one question, that is, what is homeostasis? Write its aspects and define them properly, and you will submit this assignment on your Google Classroom. Okay, thanks. Now there is another video if you want.